When it comes to power bank, everyone should be familiar with it. There are various types of power banks in the market for different devices and usage scenarios, but it's very inconvenient for people who often forget to bring a charging cable. So today we'd like to introduce three power banks that do not require external cable and compare the differences between them. The first power bank has a built-in cable for charging. The second power bank can be attached to the phone and wirelessly charge it. And the third one is very rare. It comes with a USB-C and you can directly plug it into the phone. Next, let's introduce them one by one. Compared with ordinary power banks, the biggest difference is the built-in charging cable. The cable is usually fixed and hidden on the side slot. You can even use it as a handle. Except for the built-in cable, it's also equipped with extra USB ports, so you can charge more than one device at the same time. This model comes with a lightning cable, and other models have USB-C cable. Some products integrate two kinds of cables to meet the charging needs of different devices. Most of these products are 10,000 to 20,000 mAh, so the size is acceptable. But compared with ordinary power banks of the same capacity, their size is slightly larger. Next, we're going to introduce the magnetic charging power bank. Since the release of the iPhone 12 and MagSafe, magnetic charging has been very popular. The biggest advantage of this power bank is its convenience. You do not need to find the charging port, just simply put it on the back of your phone, and you're good to go. Except for iPhone, this power bank is also compatible with Qi standard, so you can use it to charge some Android phones that support Qi wireless charging. Since there are no magnets on the back of the Android phones, it'll easily fall off while charging. Due to the size limit, its capacity will be limited to under 10,000 mAh. Otherwise, it'll be too thick to hold it or too long to fit the phone. Typically, its charging power is under 7.5 watts. Only Apple-certified products can reach 15 watts. Finally, let's talk about the direct plug-in power bank. The most well-known brand of this type of power bank is iWalk. It's pretty compact and has a charging port at the top. You can simply plug it into your phone to get the extra power, but it has the minimum battery capacity among all three power banks, and the charging performance is not as good as other products, typically under 50 watts. So if you really care about portability, you can consider this. With the above-mentioned power banks, you won't be annoyed when forgetting to bring the cable, but they all have their pros and cons. The built-in cable power bank is close to the ordinary power bank. It can not only provide sufficient battery capacity, but also has a better charging performance. The magnetic power bank is the most convenient of three products, but is limited to iPhones, and the charging speed is pretty slow. Also, it may affect your phone's performance when charging in a high-temperature environment. The direct plug-in power bank is the smallest, which is very convenient to carry around, but you need to give up the performance and capacity. So each power bank has its own features. You need to choose the most suitable one according to your own needs. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us if this video can help you to make the purchase decision. See you in the next video. Bye!